it's Super Bee Truly with BBSBs. It is Saturday, October 8th, 2022. We are going to winterize the only one hive. That's my hive tool. And we have various bugs visiting me. This hive actually had a few spiders in the tub. The wool pillow in here maybe a little bit early, but I wanted to give them a little more protection from the cooler nights. Already winterized the gnome sweet gnome hive, so look for that link in my video description. That one only got reduced to 17 frames. This one might be the same story, because when I pulled this out earlier this week, frame 13 just had 1-inch band of honey and nothing in the cells. So I need to make space for the dryer board. At least one of these has to come out. But I should only be wintering about on 8 to 10 frames in this climate. So I can't leave all of these frames in. Last frame, or the first frame when the box is filled, is always the hardest to get out. This one is loaded with honey. The hive smells good, smells like bananas. I expected not a lot of bees in the back frames. I thought they would all be clustering and only a few back here, but obviously they feel they've got some work to do. But for now, this one's gonna go in my tub because I need space to work down there. So the hive smells like Runtz bananas. It's this candy. I'm sure it's still around. And I was hoping they would just crawl back into the hive, but come on out of there. So we got one. Trim that up a little bit. Let's fly. Oop, anybody coming back up? Let's clear these. I did bring some extra frames out in case I felt the divider board did need a little stability. This is a 20 frame insulated hive, wool insulated hive. We had 3 colonies perish in this hive last year. Oh, this one's light. Half filled with honey. Oh, I meant to do my chains. This is why it's so light. Other side doesn't have any honey on it. So this one would be pulled. It's not going to stay in there for a winter nest. But I'm going to put my chains up so that they rest. Frame on there, or the wind. The wind is crazy today. So the wind doesn't catch it. This was frame 18. It's capped, fully capped on the side that was closest to the entrance. The other side is 3/4 of the way capped. No nectar on the bottom. Not quite as much propolis on the other side. That's interesting. Okay, let's see if I can finish this process here. Frame 17. Okay, that would be a good one to leave them. My Crayola from my uncle, my brother-in-law Gary. So we're gonna put for the T for take. Heavy. That one could stay for their winter food as well. Those together. Mostly capped on the other side, mostly capped on this side. Yeah. All right, and these girls are not happy with me. Open my hat. See some nectar in there. Pollen. A couple of broods. They are not happy with me. This one's light as well. chapeau and tons of pollen. Frame 10, same thing, just light with 1 inch at the top. A lot of pollen. A few broom. This is frame 9. 9 is heavier. Nectar. Nectar and honey at the top. So this is what we're leaving. Opposite side has more capped honey than this one. So I haven't been in this hive pretty much all summer. I've just been checking the end frames. I'm a new white giant to them. But I find it hard to believe that I need to leave all 20 frames for them. Let's maybe just check this one. Heavy. Okay. I feel better. This is frame 8. Oh my gosh, they have a drone right here. Drone, what are you doing? That's part of the problem. Go away. Heavy. Okay. That looks like a good winterize frame, girls. Good job. Yeah. Well, not on this side. Other side's got halfway down and kind of in a circular pattern, so this was part of the nest. Okay. I'm not gonna go looking any further. Oh, that drone was not happy with me. Why are there drones in this colony, girls? That's part of the problem. We're kicking them out. Now it's the tough part. I'm going to try to push as many as I can together at once. New plan. Colony. see the queen cups at the bottom of this frame? There are two. We did not report any swarms this summer, but that doesn't mean they didn't swarm. We might just not have seen them out at the treetops. Oh, and a tiny amount of babies.
Thank you.
And into the tote it went. I pulled 9 frames between the 2 hives today. All 9 frames have been extracted, and I'll have an extraction video being published shortly here, so look in the video description box below for a link to that video. Okay, I'm leaving him with 16 frames. I'm not sure if I'm gonna regret that decision. This hive was a little testy. I didn't go all the way to frame 1, but maybe to frame 8, 7, 6. And they had honey stores there. Saw a little bit of brood, not much. So I'm hoping in those frames that have like a 1 inch at top and some pollen, they were thinking about maybe laying in there yet. Not sure. So I may have to come in here one more time this winter, end of October, to pull some more frames. We'll just have to wait and see what the weather is. Otherwise, they're on their own. All right, this is Super Bee Sure with BBS Bees. Hopefully, it's only my only winterize video. Didn't go as expected. I thought I was going to get down to 10 frames in each hive, and that didn't happen. That hive went down to 17 frames from 22, so I have 9 full honey frames that I pull. All right, this is Super Bee Sure with BBS Bees. Buzz you later. Bye.